welcome to the Blues Asia Network on UR Face Radio. Your host, Tomcat Coleman. The only source covering blues across Asia and the Pacific.
We'll keep the train rolling, steady across the land, down along the Delta.
Hi there. It's good to have you with us again tonight. And this is a very, very special night we've got going for you tonight. I'll have to explain it to you. Because we've been working at this, building this program up, would you believe, for 15 months. And we've actually been on air on UR Face Radio now for 4.5 months. But tonight is something very, very special. And hang on, and we'll tell you about it as soon as we finish listening to our introductory song here. So there we go. We're back once again on UR Face Radio. We're broadcasting out of Manila. But as our name implies, Blues Asia Network, we cover blues all over Asia and the Pacific. And tonight, we're finally realizing the dream we've been working toward. Because we've got the show. It's been streaming here in Manila, but this week it's going to be available on demand for people all around the world. We're going international, folks, because we want the world to know what's happening with blues all around Asia and the Pacific. And this is the week it begins. So we're calling this episode number one. Even though we've been broadcasting for 4.5 months now. But this is episode number one after we go international with on-demand radio. Okay. Now, I suppose I ought to introduce myself because a lot of you will not know who I am. And I'm Tomcat Colvin. I've been living in Manila for 25 years now. Boy, this is my home. And I had the great honor of playing with a really fine blues band here in Manila. We played during the 90s and into the, up until around 2001, 2002. Our singer went off to, Binky Lampano went off to Los Angeles. But we've had some reunion concerts. And one of our reunion concerts took us to Singapore, and we played at the Mosaic Music Festival in 2005. And just so you know who I am, here's a selection from our performance there in Singapore. This is Lampano Alley at Mosaic Music Festival 2005.
Thank you. Snap your fingers. Ain't gonna hurt. Just like that. Hey! Take it easy. You gotta relax. Oh, you move, move it. You move, move it. Move, move, baby. Everywhere. Gotta mellow down easy. Mellow down easy, baby. Mellow down easy, baby, before you blow. Mellow down easy, baby, please don't stop.
Thank you.
Yeah, okay. That is Lampano Alley. And we were performing at the Mosaic Music Festival in Singapore in 2005. And it featured Binky Lampano on vocals, of course. And we certainly had a good time over there in Singapore. As a matter of fact, it was that band and those experiences of beginning to play around Asia that gave birth to the dream of the Blues Asia Network. And we've really been working at it particularly hard in the last 15 months. We have a website called bluesasianetwork.com, of course. And through that website and through Facebook, where we have a page, we have been building a network of musicians and venue owners and festival organizers and just all kinds of people that are interested in the blues all over Asia. And so we've got an incredible network of resources. And some of these folks are really engaged with us. As a matter of fact, just this week, I got an email message from a new acquaintance of mine, Ram Chung, in Hong Kong. And Ram plays with a band called Then You Suffer, a very, very fine blues band in Hong Kong. But Ram tells me that blues has sort of been on the sidelines in Hong Kong. The rock scene really dominates there. But something very, very important happened this summer. There's a major institution there called the Parkland Center, and they had a big concert featuring a number of bands, and I think for the first time, one of the bands was a blues band, one of the fine blues bands in Hong Kong. And it was Ram's band, Then You Suffer. And one of the things that was particularly satisfying is they made a video. And Ram has just gotten access to the professionally edited video, and he shared it with us. And gosh, we get to share it with you folks worldwide. It'll probably be the first time that this video has been announced to the worldwide blues audience. And we're glad to do it here tonight. And you're going to be hearing Then You Suffer. And they're going to be playing How Blue Can You Get. So Ram, take it away.
You are jealous when we are apart.
Your breakthrough performance in Hong Kong by Then You Suffer and featuring Ram Cheung. And that just illustrates that over here in Asia, we've got some very, very fine traditional blues bands. But we also, here in Asia, sometimes we take our own view of the blues and introduce some local traditions into the music. And the next video we're going to take a look at features a band from Nepal. And this band is called Asesh and Nekvam. And the amazing thing about this band from Nepal is that they tour Europe. And they have just gotten home just 3 weeks ago from a two-month tour of Europe. And in Europe, leader of the band, Asesh, he's developed the reputation around Northern Europe now as the Jimi Hendrix of Nepal. And in any case, we're going to check in on them, and they're going to start off this song with something drawn out of their local culture and then ease into something that's more familiar with international blues audiences. And one of the things that Blues Asia Network really believes in is that, we really believe in roots music. It's not just blues. It's the music that comes up out of the roots and out of the people in their common lives. And the amazing thing is that music from country to country to country, even though there are differences, it shares a lot of the same spirit. And this is a good example of it. So this is Asesh and Nekvam.
We are the Nepal band, as you already know. We're gonna play you some songs from our album, Free Spirit. First, we'd like to thank Chris Stas of Web Magazine, Baby Joe. On bass, we have Mr. Shibas. Drum, we have Mr. Drew.
Okay, that video pops out there kind of fast on us, but that is Asesh and Nekvam from Nepal, and they have just returned home from their third tour of Europe. And it just so happened that this morning I got an email from Asesh, and he has submitted a write-up about his tour of Europe, and we'll be putting it on our website. And you might want to go there and take a look, where you learn a little more about their tour in Europe. And you can find us at our website right there, www.bluesasianetwork.com. We've got a Facebook page, as you can see there. You can also reach us by email at bluesasia@gmail.com. In any case, now there's another aspect of blues in Asia that we'll be featuring in coming episodes, and that is that the settings of the blues sometimes are really especially nice. And what I'm going to share with you next is something I just discovered this video by a good friend of mine just this week, and it features June Lapito, who is one of the finest blues guitarists here in the Philippines. And June likes to hang out at a place called Puerto Galera. It's a little ways away from Manila, but it is a great place to go to. And you can find blues down there. I know of two or three blues musicians who spend a major part of the year down there. And in any case, I want you to get a flavor of what blues is like in Puerto Galera. So here we go. Well, I think here we go. Yeah, there we go. Thank you.
está semeado de flor, de flor, de flor, de flor. O sol vai se levantar para nos acolher, meu amigo.
That's my friend June Lupito, and they were jamming down in Puerto Galera. And I tell you what, I bet that makes some of you folks out there in the wide world think about, hey, maybe I better go over to Asia and check out the music scene. Boy. In any case, Blues Asia Network, we gather our material from our musician friends from all over Asia and the Pacific. We also have another interesting source of video that we like to share with you. There are quite a number of videographers, amateur videographers out there, who really enjoy documenting the music scene in their locality. And these folks have become a major source for us for music that we can bring to you documenting the blues scene in Asia. And I'd like to share with you first a video from, it's a fellow in Australia named Ross, but he operates under the handle of Rooster McBlurta. And in any case, he is very active in documenting the blues scene in Australia. And and he shares a lot of stuff that we're able to present to you here. And this one is something he just shared this week, as a matter of fact. And he caught a musician called Luke Watt at an event where he was releasing his current CD. So we're going to check in on Luke Watt, and he's performing his song, A Good Hand. And this is shared with us by videographer Rooster McBlurta from Australia.
Thank you. eyes are full of food. Sits his cell phone down, and his eyes are full of food. True thing, the duck won't break the rule. Turns his back on you. Family don't got the food that this can use.
Video shared with us by our friend Ross down in Australia, and Rooster McBlurta is the handle he uses, and he captures a lot of very fine stuff, and we're able to share it with you here on Blues Asia Network. And there is a huge amount of blues going on in Australia. I mean, just a huge amount of blues. And we get to share it with you all over the world. Okay, now we're talking about the videographers who, as a hobby, go out and document music around Asia. And there's another fellow, he's been living in Thailand for quite some time. He's a novelist, and his name is Ron, and he also goes out and documents music, mostly in Bangkok and Chiang Mai. And he just, again, has shared with us this week his latest video, and he dropped by, it's a very, very small place in Bangkok called Adhere 13th Blues Bar. And it's really small. I think they can only accommodate maybe 20 or 25 people in this place. But it is a favorite hangout for the blues insiders in Bangkok. And Ron has captured for us a performance there at Adhere. And this is by Andy Martin at Adhere 13th Blues Bar. And that performance was just 8 days ago, and we've got it for you right here on Blues Asia Network. And it's a good illustration. What we are able to do, and it's taken us months and months to get all this organized, but what we've been able to do is to gather a network of musicians and videographers all over Asia and some professional filmmakers. And these people love the blues in Asia and the Pacific. And we are able to share with you something that is genuinely unique. There's no place else on the planet where you will find this except at Blues Asia Network. And I tell you, we're honored to be able to bring it to you. And in our broadcast today, this is the day we launch our worldwide service with on-demand video. We're looking for a lot of folks from all over the world to be joining us. Now, I'd like to close out this first segment. And we usually do two segments a week. And we'd like to close out this first segment by going down to Singapore, and we're checking in with another videographer. He goes by the name at YouTube of Drum Solo, let's see, 86, but it's Jimmy Lim, and he has made a commitment to document all of the alternative music in Singapore, including the blues scene. And there is a very vibrant blues scene in Singapore with a number of clubs that actively book blues and a number of very, very fine bands. And you can learn about them all and see their performances right here on Blues Asia Network. And this next one, we're going to check in on a band called Chicken Shack Revival, led by Lewis Lam. And this band specializes in a more traditional approach, Chicago-like approach, and a little bit of rock and roll. And we're able to share this with you by the help of our friend Jimmy Lim in Singapore. And we're going to hear Flip Flop and Fly by Chicken Shack Revival.
chair. Now I get the blues, I get me a rocking chair. I get the blues so timid, now I run right away from you. Now I get lonesome, I jump on my telephone. When I get lonesome, I jump on my telephone.
Bullfrog sitting on a hollow stone. I've got such a way to jump. Fly straight, fly back, fly. I don't care if I die.
Okay, that was Louis Lam and Chicken Shack Revival from Singapore. And we have, there's so many bands out here in Asia and the Pacific. And we're going to be sharing as many as we can with you worldwide. So be sure to check us out. We'll be passing on news about festivals and special events, and we'll let you know about where the blues clubs are and some of the inside joints that you aren't going to find unless you have friends like us to tell you where they are. And you'll find all that right here at the Blues Asia Network. And you'll find it nowhere else in the world. And we're not only on on-demand TV now, but you can find us online. Check out our website. It's kind of command central, where a lot of stuff is drawn together. And really recommend that you subscribe to our twice a month newsletter, because it will really let you know things that are going on. And check out our Facebook page. That's where we pass on sort of breaking news of what's going on all over the region. And please drop us a line at bluesasia@gmail.com and share your information with us. And if you're a band or you're a venue or you're a videographer and you've got some material you'd like to share with us and perhaps on to the world, let us know about it. And if it's, we do look for reasonable quality in terms of audio and video, but let us know about it so we can get the word out there and let people know about the blues scene in Asia. And I have one last word I'd like to share with you before we pull a close to our first segment this week. And none of this would be possible without the generosity and assistance of UR Face Radio. And UR Face Radio is brand new. It's been going for 4 months. It grew out of a radio station, but now UR Face Radio has gone on the internet, and we've been invited to have a weekly live show. And so we stream live on Sunday nights from 8 to 10 o'clock thereabouts. We're a little loose out here in Asia on time, so we may be a little early, we may be a little late. But 8 to 10 Sunday nights, we stream live on UR Face Radio. And you can find us on Facebook. And just look for the Facebook page, UR Face Radio, and you can catch us live. Or, starting this week, you can find us and tune in on demand whenever it's convenient for you. And we invite you to join us every single week. And we thank UR Face Radio, which is, our agreement is we do our broadcast, we use their studio. There are a lot of other things that will be happening here we'll tell you about. And then in return, we get to take the file and share it with the world. So thank you, UR Face Radio. And you're going to hear some more information about UR Face Radio. But keep your ears and eyes open for segment two, because I'm going to introduce you to my cohort in crime. So keep your eyes and ears open for what's coming on segment two.
UR Face Radio, the worldwide Pinoy music portal. It's the latest radio innovation by the Real Music Institution, RJ. UR Face Radio, broadcasting live through Facebook. This is UR Face Radio. Local support. Filipino artists will have a new residence for sharing their music, photos, and videos with UR Face Radio's full-blown audio and video streaming from college bands, independent productions, record labels, and more. UR Face Radio will serve as your new worldwide source for Pinoy music. Live sessions. UR Face Radio will be the music fans' ultimate band channel with daily live performances. Artist exchange. Musicians and fans can interact online, live on video. From exclusive interviews, rare footage, and remote guestings, UR Face Radio will serve as the online bridge between bands and listeners. Remote concerts. With UR Face Radio's streaming capabilities, you can experience and watch the hottest gigs around the metro, anywhere in the world, direct from Facebook. UR Face Radio. Experience the worldwide Pinoy music portal in three easy steps. Log on to facebook.com/UR Face Radio. Like it and click listen or watch live. It's a whole new radio experience, providing you with a worldwide platform for Pinoy music, online, real time. This is UR Face Radio. www.facebook.com/UR Face Radio. A 20-piece orchestra, men and women dressed to the nines. 10 performers spinning, flipping, and inverting on a pole. Polarity! The Polcats Manila 2nd Anniversary Show on October 16, 2011, 7 p.m. at Film Life Theater, UN Avenue, Manila. The premier pole dancing group in the country presents a show that's never been done before. Polcats Manila performs all original choreography to Manila Symphony Orchestra, and watch as the night intensifies with special guests, Hardcore Philippines. Mark your calendars for Polarity, the Polcats Manila 2nd Anniversary Show, October 16, 2011, 7 p.m. at Film Life Theater, UN Avenue. Polcats Manila, turning your world upside down. For tickets, text 0917-701-POLE or 7653, or log on to polcatsmanila.com. Special thanks to to Century Tuna, Asta Urban Salon, Bell and Cat Nail and Wax Salon, Twinkle Ferraden, DCRJ, 810 AM, and UR Face Radio. Market Market brings you another hip and happening event this month. Celebrate Bacolod's Mascara Festival at Market Market, featuring giant mask on display, Bacolod carts and handicrafts, mural and mask making contests, and mascara photo exhibit. Be there on October 16, Sunday, from 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. at the Activity Center. Open to all shoppers. Celebrate Bacolod's Mascara Festival at Market Market. We'll see you there.